So let us see the formula now. This is the last step before we go and solve some problems in leverage analysis. I'm sure you might be knowing this formula. The first 4-5 lines is your marginal cost income statement, and the full statement is calculation of EBS. First, we consider sales. As per marginal cost technique, we divide cost into variable cost and fixed cost. Sales minus variable cost is known as contribution. If you subtract fixed cost from it, you will get operating profit immediately. From that, subtract interest, you will get earnings before tax. Subtract tax, you will get earnings after tax. From earnings after tax, we pay preference dividend first, then we get net profit attributable to the equity shareholders. Divide that with number of shares, you will get EBS. So the first 5 lines, if you see, that is operations of the business. After that, from EBIT, if you see, that is the impact of financing of the business. So, operating leverage is contribution by EBIT, financial leverage is EBIT by EBIT, combined leverage is contribution by EBIT. First, observe the performer. Observe the performer. If you observe the performer, then come to this formula. You need not write out the formula also. There are very easy formulae. Operating leverage is equal to contribution by EBIT. This means, how many times contribution is more than my EBIT? If I need to pay, if I have operating profit of 1 rupee and if I have contribution of say 3 rupees, so this will be 3 rupees divided by 1 rupee, that is equal to 3. So operating leverage 3 times means, operating leverage 3 times means. EBIT contribution is 3 times more than EBIT. If EBIT is X, contribution will be 3X. Similarly, financial leverage EBIT by EBIT means, if EBIT is say 1 rupee, if EBIT is say 2 rupees, then financial leverage will be 2. That means EBIT is 2 times 2 EBIT. Combined leverage is the accumulation of both the risks. So we multiply operating leverage and financial leverage. Operating leverage will have contribution by EBIT. In the financial leverage will have EBIT by EBIT. In this EBIT, EBIT gets cancelled in the formula will be contribution by EBIT. So combined leverage is equal to contribution by EBIT. These three are very basic ratios. Even a 6th standard or 7th standard student can easily apply this formula and get the answer. But the actual concept of leverage, the interpretation, the understanding, the knowledge part is in the remaining three formula. Operating leverage here is defined as percentage of changes in EBIT, that means operating profit, consequent to, in correspondence to, a given change in sales. That means, as I told you earlier, if sales changes by 1, with what magnitude, with what amount EBIT changes? This is operating leverage. We can say changes in operating profit by changes in sales. Financial leverage similarly is the relationship between EBIT and EBS. If EBIT changes, how EBS will change? So, percentage changes in EBS divided by percentage changes in EBIT. That means if EBIT changes by 1, with what magnitude EBS will change is explained by financial leverage. Then combined leverage, again it is accumulation of both the things. So I multiplied operating leverage and financial leverage. So operating leverage is percentage changes in EBIT by percentage changes in sales. Into financial leverage is percentage changes in EPS by percentage changes in EBIT. EBIT is translated. The formula is percentage changes in EPS divided by percentage changes in sales. Now the student will get a doubt. Sir, whether this operating leverage are the same? The answer is yes. Whether this financial leverage is same? The answer is yes. Whether this combined leverage and this combined leverage is same? Sometimes we call these three formulae as a degree of leverage. Degree of operating leverage, degree of financial leverage, degree of combined leverage we call. But having said that, there is an absolutely no difference between first three formulae and the next three formulae. They are same. 1 and 4 are same, 2 and 5 are same, 3 and 6 are same. Now you may ask, then why the differences? Why do we have two formulae? Please try to understand. First three formulae are absolute measures. That means they are calculated with the data belonging to Amir. When you come to the second set of formulae, to calculate percentage change in EBIT, first you need to know two period EBITs. So EBIT of first period, EBIT of second period, so two periods data is there, then only you can calculate operating leverage. So 4, 5 and 6 are relative measures, 1, 2 and 3 are absolute. absolute measures. So, if in the question, one variable data is given, you can calculate leverages only by using 1, 2, 3 formula. But in the question, data for 2 years is given, particularly 2018, 2019, that is 2 variable data is given. Then you can calculate leverages either by using 1, 2, 3 or by using 4, 5, 6. So, these are relative measures, these are absolute measures. One period data, you can calculate 1, 2, 3. Only 2 period data is given. In that situation, only you can calculate 4, 5, and 6. Now, the last point here to observe is how should I calculate percentage change in EBITDA, percentage change in sales, percentage change in EBITDA? How can I calculate various changes? Simple. Any change, whether it is a growth or a decline, change is equal to current year minus base year divided by base year into 100. Or easy to remember, current year minus previous year by previous year into 100. So whether you are taking EBIT, EBS or sales, simple. First take 2018 data, then subtract 2017 data from it, then you will get increment. That means 2018 sales is say 10 crores, 2017 sales is say 7 crores. So how do you calculate growth? Sales for the current year 10 crores minus sales for the previous year 7 crores divided by sales for the previous year 7 crores into 100. So like this you can calculate changes. How do we calculate change? We calculate changes always as current year data minus previous year data divided by previous year data into 100. So friends, that is about introduction to leverage analysis. Hope you understood the concepts. Hope you got the clarity. If you have any doubt, please don't hesitate to ask in the comment section. And thanks for the tremendous response. It's really motivating. It is really inspiring. The kind of support you are giving and all. Thank you so much for the love. Thank you so much for the support. If you like our classes, they are absolutely free. We do not have any intention of charging money in the future also. This is a series of video lectures only to benefit people from the different parts of India, different parts of the world. Subsequent to this, I am doing IFRS and IndAS also. Accounting standards also I am doing. So if you like the videos, please like it, share it, and give a positive comment in YouTube, and also share it with your other friends in other WhatsApp group and all. Thank you so much. Signing off, Pawan from Capital.